the United States of America today. But you wouldn't have any idea. And the idea it was based on listening to Trump. Families like the one I grew up with, the ones I saw every day. Every day I took the train home. I made over 2,100,000 miles on Amtrak over a total of 40 years, traveling back and forth 250 miles a day, every day the Senate was in session. And you know what? I'm not kidding. I used to look out the window, like I did on the way down here. Look out the window, look into the homes. The homes like I was raised in, a three-bedroom, couple of houses, nice house. Four kids, grandpa and Louis. But I look out that window and wonder what's going on tonight in that house. What are they thinking about? I really need it. After we have debate on taxes or on economic policy in the Senate, listen to what people have said. But you know what? They're the folks that, in fact, matter. You know, I can remember one night in our house, my asking my mom the next morning why Dad seemed so restless because the walls were basically paper thin in the house that we lived in. And she said, "It's okay, honey." I said, "What's the matter with Dad?" He said, "Well, we just lost our health insurance. But it's going to be okay. It's going to work out." Folks, you know what? For me, health insurance is personal. I guarantee I'm going to protect your, and you have, thank God, good private health insurance with your unions. A lot of people don't have it. 10 million people have already lost their health insurance because of lost jobs and their companies have gone out of business. And now he's going to go to court right after the election is over to try to do away with the Affordable Care Act. Costed literally over 100 million people who have pre-existing conditions. Now they're able to charge more. If you're a woman, you're going to be able to be charged more again just because you're a woman for the same service that a man receives. If you're a pregnant woman, it becomes a pre-existing condition. So much is at stake. So much is at stake here. I can remember thinking to myself when I got elected to the Senate. Right after that, I was down in Washington before I got sworn in, and I got a phone call from my first responder from the fire company saying a tractor and trailer had broadsided my wife and daughter and killed my wife and killed my daughter. And it took about 2.5 to 3 hours to get my sons out of the jaws of life because they were trapped in the car. And I remember thinking after the fact, what in God's name would I have done had I not had health insurance? I can take care of them and all the ancillary things that follow. And then, when our son Bo came home from Iraq after spending a year as a United States Major in the United States military, volunteering to go, diagnosed with terminal cancer, stage 4 glioblastoma, he's lying there in bed. Those last months we spent with him, his family, his wife, Jill, me, his brother, his sister. I couldn't imagine what it would have been like, what it used to be before the Affordable Care Act. When a company could come in and say, "You've outrun your coverage. Suffer the last 3 or 4 months in peace on your own." I promise you, if I'm elected, I will protect your health care like I protect my own family. It's that basic to me. And folks, you know, the fact is that I plan to build our country and our economy back better than it was before. As I said, I focused on the folks I grew up with. None of them are asking for anything special. Just a fighting chance. No handout. Just an opportunity. The American public, given half a chance, has never, ever, ever, ever let the country down. Not one single time. And here's what I'm going to make sure. This I promise you. I promise you. American government spends $600 billion a year letting federal contracts to everything from build ships, to staircases, to automobile fleets, tanks, the whole gamble. I'm going to make sure that every single contract let by the federal government has to be led to someone who makes it all in America. All in America. the entire supply chain. Not a joke. Not a joke. All made in America. And we're going to be able to do that in a way that's never been done before. When I'm president, the fact of the matter is, I'm going to end President Trump's tax giveaways. The companies that outsource jobs. Just since he got elected, instead of offering incentives to companies to send jobs abroad, which he's done, I'm going to change it, penalize companies that send jobs abroad, and give companies a tax break, a 10% tax break for them bringing jobs back home. We finally get control of this pandemic. We stole more than 205,000 lives and climbing. 205,000 lives is estimated. Unless we change something quickly, between now and the end of the year, there'll be another 200,000 Americans dead. If that occurs, the loss of 400,000 lives in America in 1 year is more than all the lives lost in World War II in 4 years. It is absolutely a travesty. By the way, as his director of the CDC said, if you just put on a mask like you all have, you can save 100,000 of those lives between now and January. Folks, look, the businesses are your businesses are being closed, your schools aren't back to normal, but Donald Trump hasn't done his job. He hasn't pulled Congress together to get a real compromise, to get something done. The House has already appropriated the money, to help businesses stay open, to open schools safely, to be able to allow them. Guess what? You know, initially, FEMA decided they were going to make supply masks as well as additional for both teachers and students to school openings. You know what the president said? No, don't do that. It's not a national emergency. We shouldn't spend money on that. Folks, the fact is that not only are we going to guarantee your health care, we're going to lower health care costs. The president had an opportunity on Thursday. All you got to do is make sure that we change the law that says that Medicare can negotiate prices for all health care products, all prescription drugs. That would lower prices dramatically. Under my proposal, which they pointed out would save the American taxpayers a lot of money, we're going to make sure that you not only have the care you had before in terms of the Affordable Care Act, but we're going to lower prices for drugs by close to 60%. Any new drug coming on the market is going to have to go before a board of 25 leading experts on medicine, set the price for that drug at the outset, that you make a significant profit, but you can't gouge people, and once the price is set, you can't raise that price at all other than the price of medical inflation. It'll save the American people hundreds of billions of dollars over time, as well as allow people to be able to no longer have to make a choice between to get the prescription or they're going to buy more food. And by the way, the way we pay for all of this is we're going to get rid of his tax cuts. You realize in the middle of the pandemic, billionaires in America are richer than they've ever been. They've made over $300 billion more than before the pandemic started. How about you all? You got all that kind of break? And he's got another $30 billion tax cut to lower the capital gains rate for people, the billionaires and millionaires. About time we start to reward work, not just wealth. If you do what I'm talking about, the major folks on Wall Street are not that crazy about me point out that I would be able to create, with my economic plan, I'd be able to create 7 million more jobs in 4 years than his plan would create, and I'd increase the total growth of the economy by $1 trillion more than he would. Because you know what he hadn't figured out? When you all do well, the country does well. You do well, money is spent, people are employed, wages rise, and everybody does better off. Well, look, the fact is that, as I said, this election about Park Avenue versus Scranton, Park Avenue versus Pittsburgh, I promise you, I give you my word, I will never, never break. I always tell you the truth. And when I'm wrong, I'll say so. But I'll take responsibility for what I've done. You notice he takes no responsibility. Not my fault. Governors, those blue states, those ridiculous assertions he made. And by the way, I'll never forget where I came from. I'll end where I began. Wall Street, the CEOs didn't build us America. Ordinary, hard-working people, middle class built America. And unions built the middle class. So thank you, thank you, thank you. God bless you all. And we're going to take this home. We're going to change this country. Take it back. God love you all. Thank you.